Welcome student, myself Firodiya Supnir Rajmal, working as an assistant professor in Mura Education Society College of Pharmacy, Sonai. Okay, today we discuss about the micromeritic chapters. Okay, in that first one you have to discuss the definition. Before that you have to discuss the word micromeritic. Micromeritic is nothing but the micro means small particle and meritics means measurement. Okay, so definition, according to the definition of micromeritic, the science and technology of small particle known as a micrometer. So here the word science indicates the different type of principle concept. Okay, so that are used to determine the particle knowledge, and after that you have to discuss the technology. That means you have to use the different type of meters, new technology for detecting the particles. So next one, so after the determination of particle size, that having number of application in pharmacy. So first application is physical property of powder. Physical property of powder is nothing but to determine the bulk density, tap density. After that you have to discuss the granule density. Then flow property of powder, that also depending upon the particle shape. That's why it necessary to check the particle size, because asymmetrical particle that having very low flow property, but as compared to your symmetrical particle, that's why it necessary to convert the powders, asymmetrical particles, into the symmetrical one. After that you have to discuss the rate of dissolution and rate of absorption, both property depending upon the particle size. Change in the particle size, again change in the rate of dissolution as well as the rate of absorption. Then chemical property of powder, that chemical property in the sense you have to concern related with the oxidation, rate of oxidation, again depending upon the particle size. Reducing the particle size, increasing the surface area, okay, so that enhance the rate of oxidation. After that you have to discuss the elegance of pharmaceutical preparation. Elegance in the sense of different type of dosage form, like suspension, emulsion, solution, that overall number of dosage form, that totally depending upon our particle size. Okay, so that's why particle size importance in elegance in pharmaceutical preparation. Next, stability of system. Stability of system, that again depending upon particle size. Suppose consider the stability of suspension, that also depending upon the particle size. If particle size increasing, the rate of sedimentation is also increases, that affect over the stability of that preparation. Next one, extraction and drying process. That concept, that again related with the particle size. Increasing the rate of extraction as well as the drying, that totally directly proportion to your particle size. Next one, adsorption capacity. Adsorbate over the adsorption, that phenomena known as a adsorption phenomena, and that property again depending upon the particle size. Increasing the particle size, again increasing the rate of adsorption. Okay, so these are the importance of particle size in pharmacy. Okay, so that's why it need to go for the micromeritic. In the sense, micromeritic is nothing but to study the particle size. Okay, so that means by using the science and technology, these are the combo pack. Okay, so next one, micromeritic also defined as, in another word, that nothing but to study the fundamental and derivative property of that powders. So fundamental property is nothing but you have to study the individual parameter, so that related with your fundamental property. Okay, after that you have to discuss the derived property. Derived property is nothing but property that are derived from the fundamental property. So fundamental property, first one, particle size and size distribution, then particle shape, surface area, weight and number. And derived property is nothing but the density of powder, in the sense you can say bulk density, tap density, granule density, true density. Okay, so that comes under the density of powder, because density is nothing but the mass upon volume ratio. Okay, so that means you have to use the two property, mass and volume, and that ratio is considered as the density. That's why that is the derived property. After that you have to discuss the flow property of powder, porosity and bulkiness, that concerned with the derived property. So next one, first property, that nothing but the particle size. Okay, so basically if your particle is a symmetrical in nature, is easy to express its parameter. Okay, suppose particle having a spherical in nature, its parameter is pi d square. Okay, surface area. And if you have to go for calculate the volume, at that time you have to use the pi d cube formula. By using that formula you can express the parameter. So normally particle size express in micrometer as well as the nanometer, but your optical microscope that are able to describe the particle size under the micrometer. If you want to go for the nanometer, you have to use the advanced technology. So basically micrometer's concept, 1 millimeter is equal to the 1000 millimeter, and 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometer, and 1 micrometer is equal to 1000 micrometer. These are the conversion of parameters. Okay, so next one, particle size determination. So having four method that depending upon different type of technique. Okay, first one, that nothing but the optical microscope, second one sieving, third one sedimentation, and fourth one conductivity. Okay, so that four method that having separate mechanism that work over the separate mechanism. First one optical, that means that work over the MES technology, second sieving technology, third one sedimentation technology, fourth one conductivity technology. Okay, so from that you have to discuss the optical microscope. Optical microscope, by using the optical microscope you can decide the particle size within the range of 0.2 micrometer to 100 micrometers. Okay, so these are the important, okay, within that window you can determine the particle size. So next one, it gives the idea regarding with the number distribution. Okay, that having a number of frequency distribution curve, number as well as the wave distribution curve. Okay, so here number distribution curve also converted into the wave distribution curve by using the Hatch-Catch equation. So after that you have to consider the optical microscope only used to determine the micrometer size of particle. But if you want to go for the nanometer, then you have to use the different type of advanced technique, ultra microscope, electron microscope, transmission microscope, or scanning electron microscope. By using that microscope, you can determine the particle size in the nanometer size. And its application is nothing but you have to measure the particle size in suspension, aerosol, emulsion, okay, whatever it may be. So next one, the procedure for determining the particle size. First, you have to calibration. Okay, first step in optical microscope, first you have to calibrate your eyepiece micrometer with the help of stage micrometer. So eyepiece micrometer is nothing but the simple eyepiece that fitted with graduated scale. So that means you have to consider the eyepiece converted into the eyepiece micrometer. So here this eyepiece micrometer calibrated using by the standard stage micrometer. So stage micrometer is your standard one. So one stage micrometer is nothing but the simple glass line that having graduated scale 1 millimeter, and that 1 millimeter is equal to 1000 micrometer. So you have to consider that concept, minimum 300 to 500 particle and visualize, and that diameter noted in mean computed. So next one, how to calibrate the your eyepiece micrometer by using the stage micrometer. Okay, so your first scale that indicate the eyepiece micrometer, and your bottom scale that indicate the stage micrometer. That stage micrometer consider as a standard one, it having 1 millimeter length. 1 millimeter in the sense it having 1000 micrometer size. So your it contain 10 parts, and 1 part contain 100 micrometer, and 1 part contain again the 10 division. That means your single division of stage micrometer is nothing but the 10 micrometer. 1 division of stage micrometer is equal to the 10 micrometer. So the procedure is here, you have to just compare the first line of your eyepiece micrometer that totally superimposed over the stage micrometer, and after that you have to find out the eyepiece line that totally superimposed, or you can say superimposed to the eyepiece stage micrometer. Okay, so here consider the line of eyepiece micrometer, that is 44, that totally collapse with the, that totally superimpose with the 42 number lines of stage micrometer. Okay, so consider the x and y factor. By considering the x multiple by 10 divided by y formula, you can go for to calculation the factor. And factor calculation is nothing but the simply you have to determine the whatever distance between the particle, whatever distance between the one division of eyepiece micrometer. Okay, so that you have to determine the particle size. Okay, so next one, advantages of optical microscope. So its number of advantage is very easy and simple. After that, you can say easily aggregation of particle you can detect by optical microscope. Then if you have to consider the different type of zigzag motion under the same concept, that time that type of particle, movement of particle, zigzag motion can be arrested by using the simple use of cover slip. Okay, so after that you have to consider the disadvantage in optical microscope. Disadvantage, okay, biggest disadvantage is nothing, okay, consider with the, you have to just measurement of the particle size, but you cannot measurement its height. Okay, that only related with the length and breadth, but you cannot determine the height. After that, slow time consuming, tedious method in accurate number of particle to be measured is more. It require more time to complete the practical. Okay, so these are the another disadvantage. Another one is the large sample is required. Okay, and another one, repetition of the particle, it may be chances. Okay, so these are also considered as the disadvantage. So second method, that is the sieving method, that depending upon the sieving technique. Okay, so here you have to separate the number of particle according to its particle size. So by using the sieving technique, you can consider the particle size range within a 30 to 5000 micrometer particle size. Okay, so next one, sieving method is ordinary and simple method. By using that method, you can determine the particle size. So in by using a dry powder method as well as the wet powder method, dry powder simply you have to pass the powder from different type of sieves according to their aperture size, and in wet sieves method that having another concept, if your powder in a liquid suspension or which aggregate during the dry sieving, then it's necessary to go for the wet sieving method. So next one, so basically sieving method that are used to give the weight distribution curve method. Next one, important. Suppose, okay, just consider normally near about 50% of the fine powder that are used to show the flow of materials in good compaction. But, okay, another one, percent of coarse moderate fine powder is estimated by this method. So these are the sieve methods. So in which set of sieves you have to select sieves having large aperture size that kept on top side, and sieves having a small aperture size that kept at a bottom. Okay, so that means 4 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 1 millimeter. Okay, so that means you have to reduce the aperture size. So relation between the aperture size and sieve number, increasing the sieve number, decreasing the aperture size. Okay, so that means you have to place the sieve according to their aperture size. So sieve analysis utilize the wire mesh made up of different type of material. Okay, so that avoid from the corrosion. So here that mesh size goes on decreasing from top to bottom. Okay, according to their aperture size. So method of sieving, that means you have to pass the material by using that method. Okay, first one method, that is mechanical dry sieving method. So in which first one, agitation method. So here you have to just consider the different type of motion of the particles or agitation process. One is the oscillation, that means you have to consider the sieve comes under the front and back. After that, vibration method, that means that produces the different type of vibration by providing the current. And after that, gyration, by sieve mounting with the rubbers in flywheels, that produces the gyration. Next one, brushing method, you have to just apply the brush over that particles, that means your particle goes down by applying the pressure with the help of brushing. After that, centrifugal by applying the centrifugal first. And next one, that is weight saving method. Okay, already I have discussed previously. Okay, next one, method. Here, you have to consider the sieves, 6 to 8 sieves, okay, according to their aperture size in descending order. Next one, this designation and dimension of IP specification. Okay, so here sieve number 10, that aperture size 1700, but regarding with sieve number 12, that having aperture size 1400. Okay, so that means increasing the sieve number, reducing the aperture size of that sieves. So care should be taken during the practicals. So here you can reproduce the result by standardize or by control the overall parameter. In the sense of parameter, you have to consider, you have to maintain the constant motion. Again, you have to consider the time of operation, speed, weight of powder should be fixed and standard. Okay, by using that data, you can reproduce the result. Okay, advantage of sieving, these are the expensive, simple, rapid and reproducible result. But reproducible in the sense, if you constantly or you control the parameter or standardize. Disadvantage of that method, lower limit is 30 micron. Okay, below that we cannot measure the particle size. After that, powder is moist, it may be chances to form the aggregation, attrition between the particle. Okay, during the seeking phenomena, or you have to provide the some time operation, due to that it reduces the particle size, that means it gives the false result. Okay, reducing the particle size, that means again false result. Next one, third method, that is the sedimentation. And sedimentation method also depending upon the sedimentation rate. And sedimentation rate by calculated by using the V is equal to H upon T. Okay, simple equation. But by considering the Stock law, you can calculate the stock diameter. Sedimentation meter used to determine the stock diameter. So here, simple preparation. Powder is just dispersed in a suitable solvent in which your powder should be insoluble in nature. If your powder is a slightly soluble, then you have to prepare the saturated solution. Okay, so that comes under the sedimentation meter. So another one, principle of measurement. So here, one is the one of the type is based on measurement of particle size in retention zone, and another one is the non-retention zone. By considering that concept, you have to go for the non-retention zone. That time you have to, it's necessary to describe the Anderson pipette method. So simple Anderson pipette method, which is based on the sedimentation of particle, okay, in particular solution, that totally depending upon the particle size, viscosity of medium. Okay, so that means indirectly you have to consider the Stock law. By using that Stock law, you can define the overall concept. One of the most popular method to determine the particle size by using the Anderson pipette. So that method known as the volume of suspension are drawn of concentration difference are measured with respect to the time. So next one, construction. Okay, so that construction, okay, regarding with the Anderson pipette. Okay, so these are the measuring. Okay, consider as the Anderson cylinder, and another one is the pipette. Okay, modified pipettes, that's why it's necessary to say the Anderson pipette. So pipette having 10 ml reservoir, also that having a three-way tap. So before that, you have to consider the meter, how to determine the stock diameter by using the Anderson pipette meter. You have to prepare the dilute solution, in the sense 1 gram or 2 gram of agent, okay, powder whose particle size to be determined. Okay, so considering 1 to 2% suspension, then add deflocculating agent to prevent the aggregation of particles, and then go for the collecting data. So after that, by using that equation, the particle size is determined in the terms of stock diameter measuring during the sedimentation part. Okay, formula is, okay, DST, that nothing but the stock diameter 18 mu h divided by in bracket PS minus PF bracket complete GT, okay? So here DST is nothing but the stock diameter and 18 mu H. Mu H nothing but the viscosity and H means the height of the apparatus, okay? So next one PS, nothing but the density of your particle and density of your fluid, gravitational force G, and T is nothing but the time. In this apparatus, that apparatus or cylinder that marks up to the 20 centimeter, so in which you have to just pour the sample and shake it and maintain at a constant temperature. After some time interval, you have to collect the 10 ml sample and go for the evaporation. Finally, you have to getting the residue. These are the simple method for calculating the overall data. So last one method for determination of the particle size, but that meter, conductivity meter, that used to determine the particle value, okay? So basically conductivity meter that depending upon the conductivity, okay? So basic principle is here to just consider the suspended particle that just passes from the orifice, okay? Change in the electrical resistance. Electrical resistance that also depending upon the particle size, okay? So huge the particle having the huge resistor. If your particle is small, you can consider the small resistance. So it again consider the one is the electrical stream sending zone method and another one the laser scattering method. So first one method that easily you can determine the particle value, but that depending upon the conductivity, in the sense change in the electrical resistance again relative with the particle size. And last one, that is the laser light scattering meter, that depending upon change in the light intensity, the measurement of that type of intensity, you can decide the particle size, okay? You have to go for the determination of the particle value, okay? So here, you have to consider the, okay, instrument. That instrument is nothing but the counter meter. So here, the diagram that indicate the, okay, so here, beaker contain the particle whose particle volume to be determined. That means you have to prepare the solution in electrolyte solution. Electrolyte because that having capacity to conduct the current. Okay, so that means you have to prepare the solution or suspension in electrolyte solution, and that kept into the beaker. After that, you have to consider the electrode tube that immerse into the beaker, that having a small orifice from that your number of particle, suspending particle that passes from the orifice and change in the electrical resistor. So basic principle is here. So whose powder to be a particle volume to be determined, that kept into the that beakers. So number of that suspending particle that passes from that simple orifice, okay? So during passing of your suspending particle from the orifice, that time change in the electrical resistor. So simple, so change in the electrical resistance, you can automatically note down from the electronically, okay? So here you have to consider the change in the electrical resistance. So basic principle or outline of that counter meter is nothing but the change in the electrical resistance between the two electrodes, positive and negative, okay? Change in the electrical resistance between the two electrolyte, okay, is directly proportional to the volume of that particle, okay? So that volume of particle that decide the resistance, that means that are able to decide the particle size, and then you have to collect the data, okay? Within a second, you have to count the near about 4,000 particles. It's very easy to handle. So here, advantage of counter meter, particle size ranging from 0.5 to 500 microns. Okay, within that particle size, you can measure the particle volume. So another one, number distribution, particle volume measure and can be converted into diameter. These are the accurate, very sensitive and fast technique, okay? Why we can say that these are the first technique? Because as compared to your micro sieving technique, micrometric, that means optical microscope, it requires the more time to determine the particle size as well as the size distribution. So that matter, as compared to this matter, near about 4,000 particle you can measure within a second. And most disadvantage, these are costly machines. These are the expensive machines. Okay, thank you.